The music, the costumes, the hair. There's only one ABBA. And after decades of going their own way, the Swedish supergroup is back. And talking with our Seth Doan, for the record. I was so
afraid, Fernando. Did you ever really think you'd be back producing, releasing an album again?
No.
Oh, no, no. It's strange to talk about ABBA in present tense.
And that's coming from ABBA. There was something in the air that night. Their faces may not be immediately recognizable four decades on, but their music certainly is. Swedish band sold nearly 400 million records, containing some of the biggest hits, well, ever. Friday night and the lights are low. Looking up for a place to go. Benny Andersson composes the melodies.
That's how it begins.
What are the ingredients for a good pop song?
I think a pop song should have something that you don't expect it to have. You recognize it when you hear it.
Simple yet very innocent. Knowing me, knowing you.
Björn Ulvaeus writes the lyrics. Again, note the present tense. A while ago I heard the sound of children's laughter. Because ABBA has a new album, Voyage, coming out this week. I believe it would be fair to say to look bewildered. It's their first since the group took a break in 1982.
The years after, it was very quiet. I thought that was the end of it. I honestly did. I still have
faith in you. But these pop stars who defined the 70s and are now in their 70s reassembled to record in this Stockholm studio where we met.
Bringing the ladies in, we didn't really know what to expect. Because, I mean, they're not 30 anymore, they're 70 plus. There was a union. They came in and they started to sing, and it was like bang.
Yeah,
spot on.
You write, memories we share, we need one another. I believe it's still in there. Is this a sort of theme song for getting back together?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
It's about us. It's about where we are at this point in life.
It was not just music that originally drew these four together.
It all started with us being two couples who were going on vacations and singing together, but not having the idea to form a group.
They took the first letters of their first names, Agneta, Benny, Bjorn, and Annie Fried, and called themselves by that now famous acronym. But Sweden was not exactly a music industry springboard.
It's hard to understand for someone from America or England that to come out of Sweden at that time was absolutely impossible.
You know, it's guys from Sweden.
But then those guys from Sweden entered the 1974 Eurovision Song Contest. Waterloo, couldn't escape if I wanted to. Waterloo. And the hits that followed put the Swedish band on the global stage.
What do you expect when you are on stage playing to an American audience for the first time?
I have no idea.
It's a bit scary. It's going to be a bit different.
If we create that atmosphere,
yeah, we can get
that
across,
contact, then it's going to be good, I think.
Fans loved it. Critics less so. Rolling Stone once dismissed them as muzak with vapid lyrics.
I mean, they were harsh. those critics.
Yeah, we had the wrong clothes.
And the wrong Everything image was, yeah, overall. Yeah.
But I have to say, I didn't care much. I don't think anyone of us did, because we had this huge audience that liked our records.
The two couples had married, but both divorced while the band was still together.
How difficult was that?
Not professionally.
No.
Not in the studio, not when we were working.
This is the global broadcast exclusive, sitting down with you.
Yeah.
But you were the two B's in ABBA.
Yeah.
Do you wish that the two A's were also here?
That would be wonderful, wouldn't it?
That would have been wonderful, yes.
But it was in the deal.
We'll perform. We don't want to do the press.
We don't want to do this.
No.
It's easier to say no to things when you're 74, 75.
Yes, exactly. Knowing me,
knowing you. They did say yes to a tour, but one with a twist. The idea is to recreate ABBA in the form of digital avatars that'll perform with a live band in a specially built arena in London.
There is something irresistible in this, being able to replicate yourself in zeros and ones and on huge screens with 3,000 people in the audience. It's going to be something spectacular.
During a five-week recording session with 160 cameras, they had to wear special suits with digital devices to capture every movement. The performances today will be edited with their faces of yesterday.
It hasn't been done before. That's the intriguing part of this. That's what is tempting.
It's a lot on the line.
Yeah.
But a lot of money, reputation.
Yeah, but it's only money.
The avatars are going to be even better.
And certainly a lot more high-tech than these wax versions at Olveus's ABBA Museum, which showcases the band's colorful history.
The costume folks came with ideas, and then I would adjust them to my taste.
You'd say a few more feathers or more something.
Yes, things like that.
This is quite a nice place to write a song.
It is indeed.
Away from the glitz, Olveus often writes on his private island outside Stockholm.
I find it so soothing and inspiring. To be
his process begins with the music Benny Andersson has composed.
Take a song for, Take a Chance on Me. If you change your mind, take a chance on the first in line. I was out running. But I had the sounds of the words, not the words themselves.
I guess that was a worthwhile run on that day.
It was.
How does music come to you?
Play rubbish for hours and hours, and all of a sudden I can hear myself playing something I haven't heard before that I like.
Can you show me what you mean? You'll just sit and play absolutely nothing?
Sort of, if I just go...
That's not a song.
It's not so. It's just something I play now.
That you just made up right now?
I don't know if I make it up. I just play it.
So many of your songs you recognize in the first few bars.
Yeah. That's good.
It just
takes you go. I
was cheated by you, and I think you know when. Mamma Mia, a massive success in film and on stage, introduced ABBA to a new generation.
It was an experiment, you know, to let the lyrics and the spoken dialogue become one and tell the story. Nobody had done that before.
It's an experiment that certainly worked well financially.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah. And artistically.
Yeah.
I'd say.
Artistically, they've proven their staying power and are experimenting once again.
There's been more ABBA in the world the last 20 years than the first 20 years.
Yes. She'll have faith in you.
It's kind of weird, and I'm happy and grateful.